Rick Leventhal is on the ground for us right now in Benghazi and at the site exclusively where the plane was shot down. The wreckage is behind him. Rick, what's happening?
Brian, and this is the oxygen mask from the doomed pilot of that jet that crash landed here on the grounds of a former orphanage in the southern part of the city of Benghazi. We are surrounded by pieces of that, what we believe to be a Soviet MiG fighter jet. The engine is right behind me, the fuselage, the wing, and there's a tail section in the other direction that has the old royal flag painted on it that is the symbol of the new liberated Libya. And that's why we believe, along with accounts from locals, that this, in fact, was a plane piloted by a member of the resistance, by a rebel fighter who apparently may have been shot down by his own men who had very poor communications on the ground and thought that it was a Gaddafi jet in the sky. We shot video of it yesterday. You can see the plane hit by anti-aircraft fire. Then it hurtles towards this area on fire. The pilot apparently attempted to eject, but ejected far too late. His body was recovered in this area where the plane went down in a ball of flame. The locals tell us that he was a former member of the Gaddafi Air Force who defected to the other side, that he was a family man with four children, and he is being remembered this morning as a hero here in Benghazi. Of course, there is there are jets over our heads that are enforcing no-fly zone. Last night, after many cruise missile strikes, there was anti-aircraft fire from the ground up in Tripoli that was recorded on night vision cameras. We know then that Gaddafi's military was trying to fight back against these airstrikes and against the missile strikes against their prime targets. Don't know whether any of that aircraft, anti-aircraft fire was successful. But again, the situation in Benghazi today, much quieter than it's been in days past. Yesterday morning, we woke up to tanks shelling this city. Those tanks have since retreated. The opposition fighters remain in control of many checkpoints around the city and are waving victory signs today and telling us they believe that the tide has turned in their favor.
And yet, Rick, we watched yesterday as all of the streets around you were clogged with people from Benghazi making that exodus out perhaps to the Egyptian border. Are they now coming back, or is Benghazi a ghost town?
Well, Benghazi, as I mentioned, was very quiet today. I don't know that all those people who were exiting were heading for the Egyptian border. Many of these people overnighted at friends' homes or just the homes of people in other towns to the east of us who offered people places to stay. For the most part, the people who were fleeing Benghazi were not fleeing Libya and had every intention of coming back. There may be a trickle back today, and as things get quieter here, we expect to see a lot more people coming back to their homes.
Hey, Rick, we know that the French went out and met with this new exile government, this new coalition government that would take over if Gaddafi's gone. And we met with the leaders, too, although they declared them they are the legitimate government. The French did. We have not said that. Have you met these guys? Have you met these leaders? Do you have any idea who they are or what they want? Should they be in control of the country?
I haven't personally met with anyone who's being talked about as being a leader of this country. We've met with some local businessmen in a number of different towns who are certainly heading up some of the resistance, members of the community who feel very strongly about the freedom and democracy that they want in Libya. They all tell us that members of their family or their close friends, everyone's lost someone to Gaddafi's regime. And what I would call this is a tremendous coming together of a community in support of a new democratic-style government here in Libya. I couldn't tell you specifically about who might take control, but I can tell you that the people all seem to be very much united in support of a new Libya.
Sure. And, Rick, thank you very much for getting this exclusive report because that was a big question yesterday. Who exactly was flying that airplane? Now we know that it was a rebel, one of the rebel pilots, and it was apparently shot down by his own forces. But it is so extraordinary that you're so close to it. I mean, you know, if that happened here, there'd be police tape, and you wouldn't be within a couple of miles.
Oh, absolutely. There would be investigators crawling over this scene. They would be documenting, photographing, and collecting every single bit of this former, this old Soviet MiG fighter jet. We wouldn't be anywhere near it.
Right.
But because there really is no government in place right now in Benghazi, there was no one to stop us. And there, as far as we know, been no other media to come to this location on the grounds of this former orphanage, which was once the home of a Libyan prince.
Wow.
Now just littered. And by the way, what we're being told by the locals is that they believe this pilot targeted this particular area, this cleared out area, and a home that's no longer occupied, because he knew that no one would be hurt if he crashed here, and not in either direction where there are some pretty heavily populated areas.
The last thing he did was he saved some lives. Rick Leventhal, great report, live from Benghazi. Thank you.